Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th July, on the front page you have Economic Survey sets out blueprint for $5 trillion economy. So the Economic Survey has been released, Economic Survey 2019, which was presented by Chief Economic Advisor Krishnamurthy Subramaniam. It focuses on moving to a virtuous cycle of savings, investments and exports to transform India into a $5 trillion economy in the next 5 years. It also makes a case for private investment to help propel growth in demand, jobs and productivity. So here you can see the graph given. India is the 7th largest economy in terms of GDP. So the average growth rate of India's GDP between 2014 and 2018 was higher than that of China and other top major economies. So India's growth of real GDP has been high, with an average rate of 7.5% in the last 5 years. Then this is then other aspects covered in the survey, like digital India being highlighted, the Jam Trinity, which has been done earlier, now it's called Jam Troika, that is Jandhan, Aadhaar and mobile. So this will bring in digitization, digital technology being used in the economy for the welfare of the nation. And then there is raise age of retirement, a case being made for this in the Economic Survey too. So the retirement age can be increased, it is said. So the elderly population over the next 2 decades as such is going to rise. So there'll be slowing down in population growth rate. So retirement age may be increased is highlighted. Then also it talks about electric vehicles. It says India can become a Detroit of electric vehicles. So Detroit is the capital of vehicle industry as such, automobile industry. So India can become the same for electric vehicles. So that is also highlighted in the survey. Then this is government can sell PSU land, reduce majority stake to boost non-tax revenues. So the chief economic advisor says that government has a huge amount of land, PSU land, so that can be sold off. The majority stake in PSUs can be reduced, so this will boost its non-tax revenue. Then this is regarding Kulbhushan Jadhav case. So the verdict would come on 17 July. The case is before the International Court of Justice, the Hague-based organization. So he has been sentenced to death by Pakistan military court on charges of spying for India in Pakistan, in Balochistan region. So he's under Pakistani custody. So we have filed a case at ICJ and the verdict would come now. Then on page 4 you have, Center tells High Court it is mulling rules to regulate online pharmacies. So this is the Delhi High Court where a petition has been filed. This is actually a contempt petition, because already online pharmacies, that is e-pharmacies, have been restricted by the High Court to sell drugs online. So it is said they are still selling drugs online without prescription as such. So the central government, because that verification is not authoritatively done. So now the Delhi High Court has the central government submitting before it that it is framing rules to regulate e-pharmacies, and consultations are being held with all stakeholders. Then on page 8 you have EU expertise for wind energy plants. So this is ambassador of the European Union to India who was on a visit to India. He was in Chennai and he said that India's first major offshore wind energy power plant would be set up soon in Gujarat with cooperation of EU nations and private companies. So this is regarding that, how EU expertise would be provided for wind energy plants in India. Then next is Mullaperiyar, Kerala gets 15 days to respond to plea. So the Supreme Court has given 15 days to Kerala government to respond to a contempt plea filed by Tamil Nadu on construction of a mega car parking in the water spread area of Mullaperiyar Dam. So Mullaperiyar Dam is actually in Kerala region, but it is managed and controlled and it belongs to Tamil Nadu. So this has always been a point of conflict. And here you have Bengaluru puts curbs on collection of waste. So Bengaluru has announced that it will decline mixed waste from September 1, 2019. So there will be segregation of waste becoming mandatory here. And this is a Japanese touch to Telangana Green Drive. So Forest Department of Telangana has introduced the famous Miyawaki method, Japanese method, in Harit Haram project. So here you can see what is this Miyawaki method. It is a method of afforestation. So this has been introduced in Telangana by the Forest Department in its afforestation program. And this is Polavaram project's deadline extended by 3 years. So this is regarding the Polavaram multipurpose project, in which river water linking is also taking place between Godavari and Krishna. So that project has been extended by 3 years now. Then on the editorial page, the editorial says blue sky visions. So this is regarding the ambitions of the economic survey of making India a $5 trillion economy through a consistent 8% GDP growth rate as such. So the editorial says that this ambition under the economic survey depends on implementation of the ideas. So this is just one of the ideas. There are many ideas highlighted in the survey regarding digitization, etc. Bringing growth, increasing jobs, etc. Then this is raising the bar. So this is regarding how Rahul Gandhi has forced a churn in the Congress that might lay the basis for a revival. So he has resigned from Congress presidentship, and so this is going to give a new life to Congress. Then the lead article is expanding India's share in global space economy. So this article says that ISRO should embrace a civilian identity and, aided by legislation, form partnership with the industry and entrepreneurs. So space as such, space economy should be taken advantage of. So space should be having a civilian identity. So though space has both civil and military aspects, this is a case being made here in this article. And this is talking sanctions endangering peace. So the Trump administration's successive sanctions against Iran, the article says, can only be interpreted as desire for direct conflict. So this is talking about Iran-US relations. Then on Fridays on op-ed page, you have this parley coverage. So here the question is there and views, counter views given. So this is, can the government help create jobs? So because job growth has been a cause of concern and employment rates have been at record high. So it says expansion of public employment and a national skilling program could boost employment. So this is one of the views given. So here are the views and counter views. It's an important issue in the economy presently. On page 12, you have penalty jail term to private entities storing Aadhaar data. So Lok Sabha has cleared Aadhaar amendment bill amid stiff opposition. So this bill actually replaces the ordinance promulgated in March and provides for stiff 1 crore rupees penalty and a jail term to private entities for storing Aadhaar data. It also makes the use of Aadhaar voluntary for operating a bank account, securing a mobile phone transaction, or receiving treatment in hospitals. Then page 13 has complete coverage on economic survey, all important issues in it. So it talks about how, you know, graying India must delay retirement since we are having our aging population going to increase. The trend would be increasing aging population. So we must consider delaying in retirement age. And this is needed a well-designed minimum wage system. So the survey calls for streamlining the complex mechanism and having a minimum wage mandated, which would reduce wage inequality in the country too. And then this is regarding the opposition speaking. This is private funds needed for Swachh Bharat. So 100% safe disposal of waste is targeted now. And central government already claims that 99.2% of rural India is now open defecation free. So the next big goal in Swachh Bharat is 100% safe and scientific disposal of solid and liquid waste. So this is highlighted in the economic survey. And then also zero train collisions, 46 derailments. So this is also mentioned in the survey. It says incidents related to fire are going up in rail accidents. Derailments have been there. Train collisions have been eliminated. So this is also an issue spoken of in the survey. And this is call to ease legal logjam for better contract enforcement. So economic activity is affected by delays across the legal landscape. So that is why a call has been made in the economic survey to ease the legal logjam. So there should be better contract enforcement. So this is also one of the 10 points in the ease of doing business ranking also. So this is there. Then there is no important news on the international page. Then on business page, again, you have coverage on economic survey. So this is shift focus to water productivity. So the economic survey said, as far as agriculture is concerned, country should shift its focus from land productivity to irrigation water productivity and devise policies to incentivize farmers to adopt efficient ways to use water. And then this is economic survey moves central welfare database of citizens. So it says this information can be used to improve targeting in the schemes too. So what data can do is provided here, you can see, in better targeting of beneficiaries. And this is regarding how India could host Detroit of electric vehicles. So the country sold 54,800 electric two-wheelers in 2018. So we want to become a hub for electric vehicles in the world. And this is Aadhaar-aided MGNREGS beneficiaries. So it is saying that welfare schemes, we should be using Aadhaar-based payments. So this is there for MGNREGS and it should be there for other welfare schemes also. So that is also mentioned in the economic survey. Then below you have survey calls for tax cuts, space for hotels in infrastructure boost to tourism. So it says that there's a need to sensitize states on sectors push in rolling out jobs. So economic survey has recommended series of measures to boost tourism sector, which has seen a sharp slowdown last year. So the recommendations include increased budgetary allocation for development of infrastructure, making land available for hotels, and even reduction in taxes. And this is recovery under insolvency and bankruptcy code higher at 43%. So the financial creditors have seen a significant rise in recovery after IBC insolvency and bankruptcy code kicked in compared with previous recovery regimes like debt recovery tribunal, Lok Adalat, Surfaisi Act and such. So this is also mentioned in the economic survey. Then this is reward top taxpayers, shame defaulters. So this is also a policy which has been highlighted by economic survey, saying that top taxpayers should be rewarded with diplomatic type of privileges, fast lane access, expediting boarding at airports, and even naming of buildings and roads after them. So this is what the survey highlights, that this can be done with top taxpayers. And it says that those who are defaulters should be shamed, so named and shamed. So this is an idea mooted in the economic survey. Then on business page on page 16, you have ArcelorMittal bid for SR steel okay. So National Company Law Appellate Tribunal has rejected Ruya's plea challenging eligibility, and ArcelorMittal's bid for SR steel has been okay. So proceeds of the sale shall be shared among creditors now. Then on the last page, you have scientists find new gene linked to schizophrenia. So collaborative efforts between Indian and Australian teams aim to shed more light on this mental disease. And this is Arctic mission to track researchers in ice to study climate. So you can see that there are 17 nations which have come together and have teams here in the Arctic region. They will take part in this year-long program where a research ship will allow itself to get stuck among floes in the ocean. So it will get trapped in ice to study climate. So this is there. And the last one, fingerprinting to track users online is on the rise. Here's what to do. So the technique, which involves looking at device characteristics and triangulating data to follow users, happens invisibly in the background in apps and on websites. So this is like fingerprinting of users online. So how can this be tackled is mentioned in this article. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.